So my pleasure to introduce, we have one more speaker before lunch, and that's Alex Navrotsky. As you know, Alex has been one of the true leaders of MSA, Roebling Medal winner, president, and she has recently taken a new position, moving from the University of California, Davis to Arizona State University, where she has the opportunity to begin a new program called the Materials of the Universe.
So I realize that I'm standing between you and lunch, but I would like to give you some food for thought first. We already heard a lot about planetary science in the solar system, with emphasis on Mars, the moon, things that are extending terrestrial geochemistry. But I say that the universe is much broader. And if we take a look at what we've learned in the last decade and the last several years, we've learned from planetary missions that the solar system is much more dynamic than we ever realized, that the outer planets are not just cold pieces of ice that do nothing, that in fact they and their moons and so on may have very dynamic, perhaps even life-friendly environments, that planets like Mercury have very different surfaces, probably different interiors. This exploration is going to continue. But perhaps the most exciting thing, perhaps the biggest paradigm shift since plate tectonics, has been the discovery of exoplanets. The discovery that exoplanets are frequent, that they are the rule rather than the exception. Oh yes, of course, we have data sampling problems, what we can detect. We're at the beginning of this field. People who are starting out in it, people whose career will span 30, 50, 60 years, are going to have information that we cannot possibly dream of. So this is tremendously exciting. But in a sense, basically, what we're faced with, and here I show my bias, I'm trained as a physical chemist, and I have worked probably equally in the mineralogy geochemistry field and in the solid state chemistry material science field. So I view, in a sense, exoplanets and even solar system mineralogy as a tremendously exciting exercise in the biggest inverse problem that material science has ever had to face. That is, what is an inverse problem? A direct problem is one in which you have a material, you want to know its properties. An inverse problem is one, you have a few observations of the properties of a system, you want to know what that system is, you want to know what its materials are, you want to know what its history, what its evolution is. That is what we're faced with, certainly with the solar system, but all the more so with exoplanets. So given that, we need to have a real synergy between material science and planetary science. We've heard a lot about the planetary science part of it, the geochemistry part of it, but let me remind you that we are dependent on techniques. We're dependent on detection. These, in turn, are dependent on materials. So if we look more broadly, if we, free ourselves from the tyranny of just the Earth's geotherm, if we think of what sort of materials might be out there and how we might study them, clearly some materials are amenable to experimentation, high pressure, high temperature, but also low pressure, low temperature, condensation from the nebula, what happens in ultra-cold environments where ice does not flow, what happens when there are different sorts of ices, what is the chemistry, mineralogy on the shores of hydrocarbon lakes, if those really exist, etc. Those are problems that materials, that chemistry, that physics need to address, sometimes by experiments, sometimes by theory, sometimes by a combination of those, sometimes by looking at the few observations that we have in natural systems. So we need a synergy between materials. We need new materials, new sensors, better detectors, better spacecraft, better materials, better understanding of radiation damage, better understanding of the effect of radiation in space on biology. All of these are very broad sorts of things. So I view this science of materials, if you will, of the universe as really broader than what we've seen so far. And I would like to then say that the opportunity that we have created at Arizona State University that brings me there is basically a center for materials of the universe. The goal is to bring together the people that work in chemistry, physics, engineering, with the people that work in largely CC, the School of Earth and Space Exploration, that goes all the way really from astrophysics to geochemistry to environmental science, and to say that these things need to help each other over the long term. And we are developing a center. We have seed funding. Of course, we will need to get major grants. We will have some faculty positions. I am moving. In fact, I'm moving house next week. I'm actually moving to start at ASU this fall, this October 1st. And I welcome collaborations with all of you, because although the effort at ASU is going to be a center, it's an outward-looking center, and it's really all of us that form the universe of science, and mineralogy certainly is part of it. And I thank Peter and the organizers to give me a few minutes to tell you about this and to share my excitement. Thank you.